load by zone. Like you can provide the values here. Like the most like used parameter here for design airflow method is design day, and that's when the design day weather file is used. Okay, if you are running an baseline model, I would ask you to use this design day method. Then you need not to worry about all other parameters here. Like for example, the first one is flow per zone. You need not to worry about filling this one. Okay, if you make something like design day with limits, well, like you know, I would prefer like use this design day. In case you want to read what these like different parameters do, you can always go to Energy Plus documentation, go to input output reference, and you can do a quick search here. For example, what if I want to look for something like, let's say, cooling minimum airflow fraction, let's say what it does. So I can just perform a real quick search here. It used to be a different version of the input output reference, or actually this documentation, but now they have created this PDF for you, which I personally don't find very user friendly. The previous version was more friendly, but it is what it is right now. So let's say we want to do something like cooling sizing factor. Again, like it's searching through PDF, so it can take some time. Let's say, I mean, it can take some time, I know, like, so you can see this, it has like 36 those parameters. I mean, now you need to go through all of them one by one, but you can see this is the cooling sizing factor. Like you finally can figure it out. Let's say like, if I want to go through what is happening in this section, you can see this is for sizing here, you can see. And what if I want to look for cooling sizing factor?